Put your hands together and welcome. Oh, let me just say this. Brother Luke, I didn't know this about this man. I just had to say this. Come to find out, in his spare time, he trains the special forces in self-defense and, what is it, MMA style self-defense. I didn't know he was bad to the bone too. So I guess that means we better give him a good offering. If you see me come to church next service with a crick on my neck, you'll know he choked me out. Put your hands together and welcome the man.
Come on, we clap your hands to the Lord. Oh, we love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, everyone. It is such a privilege and an honor to be in the house of the Lord. Man, I feel such an anointing in this place. I feel like God's going to do something. I feel like somebody's going to leave with a miracle. Somebody's going to leave with a blessing. Somebody's going to leave with a need met. Somebody's going to leave with a situation that's changing in your life. I believe that's going to happen today. Do you believe that? Do you believe that? Why don't you clap your hands to the Lord in affirmation? Hallelujah. You may be seated for just a moment. I am so excited to be here. It is a privilege and an honor to be here. I want to quickly say that I want to honor your pastor and his wife. Amen. Some of the greatest Christians that I have ever had the chance to meet and to spend time with, and you all are blessed with the leadership that God has given you. The angels of this city, and Pastor and Sister Alicia, great, great people of God, and I honor you so much. Thank you so much for letting me be here. I want to quickly say, I'll give a shout out to Savannah, great, talented young lady. And pastor had said, you know, do y'all sing or do anything? You feel free to do anything. And I said, who needs to sing when you got Savannah here? But I do need to buy a little bit of time because I worried our sound folks with a bunch of scriptures this morning. And just a few moments ago, while sitting over there, the Lord has changed my message. I don't apologize for the change, but I do apologize to our sound people. I love y'all. So I'll give you one scripture that makes you feel better. Psalms chapter 23 is what we'll be looking at. But while they're trying to get that, would you worship as I try to sing? Nothing else can take the place. nada bastará. With Jesus Christ. And this morning, if you have your Bibles, if you have a Bible app, feel free to open it to Psalms chapter 23, very familiar verse. I came with a totally different message. Sound and folks can completely agree with me. They were stressing because I gave them all kinds of scripture. I had something planned out and said, you know, this is what I'm going to do. So leave them hanging off the chandeliers. The Lord changed my mind and changed the message this morning because I feel like He wants to talk to somebody. I really believe that. Psalms chapter 23, very, very familiar scripture, says this: the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
Right. Yep.
That means I don't have to worry about anything.
Right.
He maketh me to lie down in green pastures, and He leadeth me beside still waters. This morning, I want to speak to you for just a short time. I promise I won't be long, but I'm going to speak to you on this subject. I'll break you for your breakthrough.
All right, that's right.
I'll break you for your breakthrough. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I'm asking you right now that you would fill this house with your presence, oh God. Touch, oh Lord Jesus. Take my mind and my mouth and use it as you desire, oh Lord God. Open our hearts and our minds, oh Lord Jesus, that we may receive what it is that you have for us. In the wonderful name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for your mercy and grace. In Jesus' holy name. And everyone say amen.
Amen.
Why don't you clap your hands to the Lord as you're seated. I know we've read numerous numerous times this scripture, very familiar scriptures in Psalms chapter 23, how the Lord is our shepherd. And many of us have probably heard a message that it sounds similar to how the Lord will reach for you. No matter where you go, no matter where you try to run off to, that God will go to the extent of breaking your leg just to grab a hold of your attention. And that's a great message. I don't want to take anything from that. But this morning, I hope to encourage somebody. I want you to see a different side of the breaking that you're going through. Because, see, in 2017, this year that we just passed, many of you that are sitting on these pews have faced some of the greatest challenges that you ever faced in your life. Some of you have dealt with situations and you've dealt with things and you have even asked God, why is this happening to me? Some of you have dealt with problems in your family and problems at home and problems in your marriages, and maybe even this church has dealt with issues and situations and things. I'm not sure, pastor hasn't talked to me, but I feel in the Holy Ghost that there has been some hurting and some breaking, some things that people don't understand why I'm facing it. And you may be looking at those things and saying, God, are you mad at me? And God, I've been trying to do what's right. I've been paying tithe and supporting and trying to do what I'm supposed to do. Why? And I'll just be honest, be very transparent with you this morning. This message is my testimony.
All right.
Because as I was going through some things, I started to read this and I started to look, you know, the Lord is our shepherd. I can go into a series of accolades of how he is a great shepherd in my life. And I'm so grateful for how God is and how he does in my life. It is he that leads and guides me every day. It's he that loves me unconditionally. You know, I just get beside myself when I begin to think of how God has been good to me and how he brought me out of darkness into this marvelous light. He looked at me when I was in a miry pit of sin and looked at me and said, you know what? Even in the mess that he's in, I love him. And you know what he did? He reached down and he picked me up and he washed me thoroughly. And it's because of that I'm able to stand before you. And I can tell you with every bit of my heart, I love him. He has become my passion. He is my desire. I want you to know that from the outset of this message, I want you to know that I feel like somebody in here has asked the very question, God, what is it that you want from my life? What is the desire that you really have for me? And if you've been in this place and you've been praying that, God, what is it that you want from my life? I need to know what it is that you truly desire from my life. I believe the answer can be found in Psalms chapter 51 and verse 6. See, it says this, thou desirest truth on the inward parts. I looked at this word truth, and the word is a derivative. It is chemeth, and it means it has a direct correlation to John 14 and 6 when Jesus said, I am the way and the truth. What Jesus is saying here is that what I desire more than anything is to be on the inside of your heart. I want to be on the inside of you. I want to know you. I want to be in love with you. I want you to be passionate about me.
That's right.
See, we get this kind of mixed up because we believe that, you know, that wisdom and knowledge and those things right there are what it's all about, and that they're one and the same. But let me tell you, there's a big difference between wisdom and knowledge. Very, very big difference. And for some reason, we have a tendency to believe that, you know, my life life should be this certain way, and because I'm a Christian, I should live this way, and I should have all the good things in life. But let me tell you something. Just because you're a Christian doesn't mean you're not going to worry. Just because you're a Christian and you're baptized with the Holy Ghost doesn't mean you'll never have a problem or a worry or a fret. Those things are going to come. But hear me in this place. One of the things I think we've confused is the Bible says that the joy of the Lord is my strength. Begin to ask for a wisdom of God. See, he said, I would make wisdom to be on the inward parts. He didn't say, I'll have knowledge on the inward parts. He said, I'll make wisdom. You know the difference between knowledge and wisdom? Knowledge, there's a lot of people that know about a lot of things.
Yes.
But wisdom comes from experience. And I believe that I'm speaking to a group of apostolics that have had an experience with Jesus Christ. You can't just tell me Jesus, but you can tell me that he is the one true God. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one. You know without a shadow of a doubt that without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. For God was manifested in the flesh. Hey, you know why we're coming? Because we know who he is. Your passion. option is going to cost you something. And the cost is a broken leg. What? We've heard that phrase before. Break a leg. Sister Savannah, you probably heard it a lot. You go up to sing and say, break a leg. My research of this, I find that it's very misused. We feel like it means to good luck, do a great job. But the history of the word or this phrase, break a leg, comes from when John Wilkes Booth killed the president, Lincoln, in the Ford Theater. What happened was when Booth had killed the president, something bad happened. When Booth killed the president, he was trying to get away out of the building, and he was on the balcony, and he realized, hey, I can't get out because they got me trapped there, and they got me trapped there. So what happened was he stood on the balcony, and he leapt from the balcony onto the stage where everybody was paying attention to the actors. And then when he landed on the stage, his leg broke. And all the attention of everybody that was looking at the actors now were all on Booth. And so let me tell you something along with this scripture, because before I get to what I want to tell you, there was a study that I started doing about sheep, because that was our main scripture. And I came across this amazing story. And it was about a sheep. Some of y'all look at me like, where is he going? Let me just pause right here and get you just moving just a little bit. The reason why we tell you to break a leg, the reason why we want you to really break a leg, is that what it really means is to do something that's going to capture your audience's attention. And if you ain't figured out, this is the stage of life. The devil's watching you, and so is Jesus. And I wonder what would happen if folks in this church would begin to carry their life out like Jesus was watching me. What did I do to get God's attention? You want me to tell you how you get his attention? Your praise is how you get his attention. Your praise should be exuberant. Your praise should be step outside of the
You see this young man right here? He got a testimony. That's how you break a leg. Praise him. Somebody need to remember what God brought you out.
Recounted this. He said the strength
strangest thing happened. It was like the moment I grabbed him, after I had just broken him, the moment I grabbed him and picked him up, it was like the pain eased.
Bro!
church and sees your life is going to know you've been with the shepherd. Everyone that sees you, young man, you think they're going to look at your pain. You think they're going to see what you went through. You think they're going to see the mark that you're left with. But hear me, the one thing that they will know is that you've been in his arms. Anybody knows me, knows I'm shy. You know, I like to move, I like to do things. When I broke my leg, Pastor, I couldn't do nothing. You know what, I was in bed just like this. Couldn't move, couldn't do nothing. And I grabbed my Bible one day and I said, why'd this have to happen to me? And when I opened up my Bible, it landed on Psalms 23, verse 3. He maketh me to lie down. Some of you are too busy. You're doing too much. You're so busy and well-doing that you forgot what you're doing it for. And so every once in a while, he has to make you lie down. You know why? To restore your soul. And somebody in here needs some restoration. Somebody in here has been hurting for far too long, and God just wants to take you in his arms. And he just wants to love on you for a little bit. We're not looking at your problem. We're not looking at what you've gone through. We just want to see you better. And God is in this place, and he wants to hold somebody and heal your hurt. But you know what the problem is? We get wounded, and the minute we get wounded, we want to start covering up. I don't want nobody to see that. I had a surgery a number of years ago. And after surgery, the doctor bundled me up. And he put this patch on me, and he said, now you make sure you keep that covered, son. I said, yes, sir. About a week and a half later, I was so careful with that thing, I didn't want it to get infected. It left a hole in me. It looked like I had been shot. So I was covering it real good. About a week and a half later, I said, surely there's some healing going. And I remember removing the gauze, and it looked just as fresh as the day I got out. And I went to the doctor, and I said, doctor, what's going on? Is no healings happening? He said, have you kept it covered? I said, yes, sir. You told me to keep it covered. He said, no. Just when you go out. But when you're alone, you need to expose it. Because only with exposure comes healing. And some of you have been covering up your hurt, wounded brokenness, and you don't want nobody to judge you, and you don't want nobody to see what you've been going through. But hear me, you're in the house of God, and you're in front of the master, and he just wants to see if you'll expose your hurt to him so he can begin some healing. He's here today, and he just wants to heal you. He wants
to heal this church. Because he'll break you before your breakthrough. And your breakthrough is on its way. 2017, you suffered and you broke and you didn't know why. And you thought he was mad. But hear me. The building. And those of you that are hurting, I want you to put in your mind for just a moment and say, God, I've been looking at this all wrong. I thought you were mad. I thought I did something wrong. But I understand now. You just want me to be closer to you. So I am willing. Right now, won't you come? And God is going to start healing some of you. God has already put it in my mind to deal with two of you, but I don't want to embarrass anybody. Won't you come? Won't you come? God's going to heal some things right now. God is restoring some people. God restoring people to their positions. God is restoring this church. Begin to pray, God.
there's going to be a whole fresh anointing fall on this music section right here. Excuse me, y'all pray. I want God is doing to in the name of Jesus. The heartache and the pain.